talked about a lot last week, so I just want to kind of check in with you and see how everything's going. See if anything that's important that you want to talk about right now.
Okay. I don't know. I think I'm just feeling like there's just like so much going on, and I don't know how to deal with it all. Like, you know, last time I told you about how, like, I have a really crappy roommate, and, like, she's just so loud all the time, and I just can't be around her. And then, you know, I can't study, and so I'm not doing good in my classes. And let's see what else. I just, like, I don't know, I just like have so much going on. I have like, you know, school and then them and then, you know, I don't know what I'm doing with my life yet. And I feel like I'm 18, I'm an adult, I should have this figured out. But, you know, I don't yet. And like I have no friends, like I sit in my room and I just try to study but then I can't because of the roommate. It's just so much stuff.
But it seems as though you're feeling really overwhelmed right now. And that can be really difficult in a time where there's a lot that you need to kind of juggle and balance.
Yeah. I mean, like, cause I did fine in my high school. Like, I was, you know, I had good grades and a lot of fun. And, like, I, you know, I was able to handle it all. And now I don't know what happened. Like, I go to college and it just all blows up in my face. So it's kind of like, am I even supposed to be here? I don't know. I just, it's too much to handle.
That's a big question to have to ask yourself.
Yeah.
That's,
I mean, I don't know. It's like, I miss my family and I don't get to see them, you know, for the whole semester because they're far away. So it's like, I can't talk to them unless it's on the phone. And I just feel so alone.
And I just want to ask you, how, or like out of any of these things that you are struggling with, because it is a lot, you're right, when you're saying it just seems like it's a lot, it is. I mean, you listed off like 10 things.
Yeah.
If you could order them into kind of like what is something that you just really can't handle right now and is the most important thing that you want to tackle, do you think you can give me like a top three of those?
I think just, you know, not really having anyone to talk to other than, you know, my parents on the phone, but, like, I thought college was going to be this great event where I got to meet all these people and, like, you know, you hear about the parties and stuff like that, and it's like, no one invites me to parties, and I just, you know, I sit in my room and I eat pizza, and it's like, that's not what I thought college was going to be like, and I mean, my roommate, and I think just, you know, I want to be able to have fun in college, and I want to be able to have that experience that I thought it was going to be, because, like, I'm not even doing good in school. It's not like I'm, like, studying hard all the time and, like, getting good grades. So I have one good thing going on in my life, it's, like, they're all class right now, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
I don't mean to cut you off, but I just kind of want to understand what you're mentioning. So, not, you know, the social aspect of school is really important to you. So the fact that you don't have anybody else except for your family, you miss your family.
Right.
And your roommate is kind of, you know, somebody that you're supposed to get along with really great. That's not really working out, so it's kind of affecting your academics.
Right.
So, you're saying you miss your parents, and just talking to them on the phone isn't really enough.
No, because I mean, like, you know, I'm very close to them, so I used to be able to talk to them about anything, and I still can, but there's not much that they can do from, you know, 5 streets away. So, I mean, and I have my friends from school, but like high school, but they all have their own lives now, and, you know, we talk on the phone or Facebook or whatever, but they all have stuff going on, and it's like, I don't, and so, you know, they don't even want the same level, so, I don't know, I want to be able to figure out how to, you know, maybe make some friends, or like, I don't know what it is, because, I mean, it's nothing is going the way I hope, so,
Maybe.
I think Nathan Fine would be the first one. Like,
okay.
Not in so long.
So, I know this might seem like a really silly question, but how do you like to make friends? Are you really outgoing, or are you a little bit more shy?
Well, in high school, I was not shy, but I mean, I grew up with those people in a very small town, so like, everybody knows everybody, and you know, here it's this true state college, and like, I mean, I didn't get along with my roommate, and I always had that roommate supposed to be like, you know, your best friend, and you know, you always hang out with them, but she's always with her boyfriend, and they're always like making really loud, you know, they're playing loud music and stuff like that in our room, and it's just like, she doesn't care about my feelings, and I mean, it just, so I think I've gotten maybe more introverted just being here, because I'm not like, I don't know how to reach out to people that I've never met before.
And it can be an extremely difficult task to kind of all over again have to learn how to socialize with people.
Yeah.
It's not easy. You know, it's really easy when you have someone in common to meet new people. Like, I call them a buffer, which is someone that you know, you go to a party, you know this one person, and then they introduce you to other people. So it makes it comfortable. But it seems like you don't, and
like, I don't even have that buffer.
Yeah.
So it's like, I don't even know what it's about.
How would you like to start? Is there something that interests you that you could meet people with naturally, kind of during the group? It seems like maybe sitting in your dorm room, and
yeah.
Tell me if this is wrong, and it seems like that's not working out very well with your roommate being there and not being able to study.
Yeah, because I mean, like, in my room, I just like put my headphones on, and then I just, you know, I read or I chatted to my homework, but it's hard to do when, you know, the door is always opening and closing, and, you know, people are coming in and out, and it's like, I don't know, but I mean, I could go to the library, I guess, or, like, maybe into, like, one of the lounges, but, I don't know, but then that means, you know, there'd be other people there, and they would, I don't know if they would want me there or not.
Why do you think they wouldn't want you there?
Well, because, like, they all have their own because, you know, I started in the spring semester and everyone else started in the fall, so it's like they already have their established groups of friends, so I'm kind of like coming in here like, hey, and I mean, you know what I mean, it's just
it can be really
hard,
scary,
yeah,
to try and just open up to yourself to people and then kind of wait for them to accept you, so you don't, you know, you're waiting for acceptance or rejection.
Yeah.
And rejection can be really scary.
But, I mean, I don't know, I think, I just, it's just like I said, it's like a lot to handle, and it's like, I don't know how to deal with that, because, like, I told you a while ago, I used to cut myself, and like, it just feels like it's so overwhelming, and I don't know how else to do with all of this. Or I eat, and so it's like I know I'm smart enough to know that neither of those things are good for me, but what else can I do? And
what do you think we can do? What do you think is something that will help? With the cutting, would you like knowing different coping skills for that? I mean, I know that's something that we talked about earlier, but learning different ways to kind of handle those emotions.
Yeah, I mean, like, I've learned some of them, but I don't think I've ever used them. But, I mean, I think it would help maybe if I, you know, met someone else that was going through it, because I don't know if there's anyone else here on campus, because it's not something that people talk about, but, you know, maybe if I could talk to someone else,
trying with one that would kind of fit what you're looking for. And
okay.
They can be really difficult to enter at first. It's intimidating. But from what have clients told, from what previous clients have said before, is you just need to break that barrier of walking in that room, and you can be the most awkward human being ever. I had a client who spilled his entire 7-Eleven slushy on him because he was just so nervous and he was shaking.
Yeah.
But once that passed, he realized that everyone's there for the same thing. You know,
right.
When you see someone in public and they kind of embarrass yourself, how do you feel about that?
I think I could do it. I think I would just, I don't know, maybe I could pack with it or something, but I think I could do it. I'm not used to telling other people my problems. You know, like I said, in high school, I did really well. And so
well,
now, kind of like, I feel like I've been the table of the time completely. And so now, for me to be the one that in this situation,
and you don't have to go there to talk about your problems.
Okay.
You can just go there and sit and listen. Sometimes just hearing that other people have struggled can be comforting in a sense.
They won't care that I'm just like sitting there?
No.
Okay.
Most people don't necessarily just go to groups.
Okay.
For shits and giggles.
Yeah, I mean, I would try it. I just,
and you know, this could be a place where maybe you can just pull someone aside and be like, hi, I don't really know what I'm doing. Because now, you know, maybe this is a place of new people and it might not be your roommate or
like,
you'd be like, I can just talk to you and you can just hang out with.
Yeah, I would try it. It would help me, I think, because like, I need to find something else that's gonna work, because I can't just keep doing that. I can't keep eating all the time, and it's like that's not helping me. And I don't know, but I mean, one of the things too is like, do you think that I could get a new roommate, or do you think I should just like, because I was talking to my parents. Into a house or my own room, but then I don't know if I would just sit in my room all day again. So it's like, it's just, there's so many things to think about.
Well, what would be the best solution for you right now? If you just, it doesn't matter, and you just get that to happen.
I think I would feel better just maybe having a new roommate, or like, just because I've tried to talk. She's not. There's no way. I know that there's no way that we would ever be fine. There's just no way. So.
And sometimes people just don't mix.
Yeah.
So, is there anybody you think you can talk to find out if that is an option?
I didn't know if that is something I could do or not. But, I mean,
well, usually, if you don't know, you just ask, right? No, what's worse if they can say no?
But,
okay. So, it seems like we're kind of getting somewhere where I can have, if really mean, I really think that attending a group can help you. I can most certainly let the secretary know, and she can give you the list of all groups on campus that we offer. And, I mean, do you have public, or do you use the public transportation, or do you have your own form of transportation?
I have a car on campus.
Okay, so if you'd like, we can also give you resources around the community. We usually don't keep them very far. It's, you know, 15 minutes max to drive somewhere. If that's something that you think you
I could do, like, what if I go though and they don't, like, I don't like it. What if that happens? If I go and I feel that.
No one's forcing you to stay. You're not chained to a chair. You know, if you don't feel comfortable, you always have the option to walk out.
Okay. sometimes, like, I'm judging them a little bit. But I don't know. I'm always worried about, like, I think a lot about what people think of me, but I mean, like, I wouldn't want them to think I'm judging them about evil or something like that, too. So, I don't know. But if I can go and just, like, sit there and just see if it's for me or not, yeah, I would do it. So. Yeah.
Okay, so I can get you the information to come up and, you know, that maybe can help you with the eating and self-harming.
Mm-hmm.
And kind of meeting new people and finding new people that you can talk to.
Okay.
And then you mentioned speaking to your RA.
Okay.
If you need any, he tells you the name of a person on campus. I'm sure we have their information here too, so you can give me a call at any time. And
okay.
I can give you their direct line.
That sounds good.
We can, you know, if you want to send a letter to someone, I can most certainly read it for you and we can look it over. Make sure everything looks great. So, you know,
okay.
If you just think that would be helpful, I'm more certainly
okay.
Able to do that.
I really appreciate that because, like, you're the only person on this campus I know that I've been talking to, so I really appreciate that.
Well, I'm really glad that you feel that way. I'm always here. You have my number, so you have my emergency number.
Okay.
You know, somebody else will answer, but they will get a hold of me if they,
okay.
That they know that you need to speak to me.
Okay.
And anybody here in this center is able to speak at any time if you need them, and you just need to walk in.
Okay.
We all keep the notes on the same drive, so they can just pull everything up, and they don't have to keep doing this, like, let me know what's going on.
Right.
But they can
right.
Just read it really quickly, and then they kind of have an idea, and they
okay.
Can help you as much as they can. Is there anything that you want to touch on? Anything else?
I don't think so. I think you helped me a lot. With, you know, you're going to help me get some new places that I think it'll be cool.
Okay. So I just want to make sure, kind of want to know how you feel about everything, and then if you could just kind of tell me what you were going to do in the homework. Cause,
it's still hard, but I mean, I think, like, I'm going to try to go to the group. I'm going to, like, try to do, I'm going to talk to my aunt and see how that goes. And see if I can get an agreement. I'm going to I think those are the two main things.
Yep.
But like if I could meet someone that like, going through the same stuff with me, maybe that'll help. So I'll try that. And that's more than, you know, I've done before. So I would try that. And then if I get a new roommate, that'll all be better, and then maybe I can study. So hopefully, like, you know, I'd be doing a little bit better. So.
Yeah, I'm excited to hear the progress. If you at any point have any questions, like I said, feel free to give me a call. And then if you need an extra appointment, you need to see me twice a week, feel free. I have times available. And
okay.
You know, I don't foresee anything happening, but just in case, we are always here.
Okay. And so do we have another meeting or are we just am I okay for now?
Well, last time I checked, I thought we had our weekly meeting scheduled. I can double check. We can talk to the secretary up front and make sure that's still
okay.
Scheduled. But if you feel like you need to see me more than once a week, you can give me a call at any time.
Okay, cool.
All right. All right. I'll talk to you up.
All right.
Hi Claire, come on in.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
I'm alright, I guess.
You guess? What is that supposed to mean?
I don't know. Things still going rough, but I mean, I'm trying, I guess.
What's going rough for you?
Well, I mean, still not sleeping that much. I'm still having suicidal ideation.
Okay.
Thinking about harming sometimes, but I try and refrain myself.
Okay. Are you having any of those ideations right now?
No. Usually when I come here, I try and I kind of feel a little bit better because I mean I like seeing you, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you have that phone number I still gave you just in case you are having any of those thoughts or ideas?
Yeah, I have it programmed in my phone.
Okay. Good. I'm glad to hear that. I know you did talk when we just saw each other last time about your sleeping and how you're having some issues with that. And you said you're still having them right now. What's going on? Are you just restless?
Yeah, I just keep thinking about everything. And all night, I toss and turn, I toss and I turn. And I can't focus on anything of the same sort. Like, it'll be one thought, and then the next thought, and then the next thought, and it just keeps going and going, and like, all night long, I'm just tossing and turning.
Okay.
I can't.
So it's like your brain's not shutting off.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah. I can be thinking about school, and then I'll be thinking about, oh, I have to do this, and I have to do this, and then I'm thinking about all this other stuff that's going on, and I just can't focus at night.
Okay. So, do you think that there was a time that you weren't feeling that way?
Maybe beginning towards like high school.
Okay, so like 15, 16?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I didn't really have much to worry about. Now I just feel like there's so much on my plate.
So you feel more worried?
Not so much worried, but just what next? So I mean, I guess you can describe it as worry, but I'm like, I have a lot of anxiety about everything. I guess it's just new stuff that I'm trying to get used to, but it's not happening.
Okay. Is new scary to you?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm not a big fan of new stuff. I like being in routine,
Okay. Knowing
what's gonna happen next.
Okay.
High school, I didn't have to worry about that stuff. It was just like, I feel like they didn't prepare me that well. Felt like I was more babied, I guess.
Okay.
Everything was there. I knew everybody, and now I'm here, and there's all new faces,
mm-hmm.
and my mom's not here, and
yeah. That can be scary. No,
yeah.
I understand. Do you think that with school, just not having a support system, possibly, or is it just everything's overwhelming and just not having anything?
Everything? Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, my mom literally, if I needed help with something, she was there.
Okay. Well, that's great. You have her number, though, correct? And
yeah, but I can't keep calling her for everything.
I mean,
18 years old, I kind of, I gotta get away from home somehow. I mean, this is like the first step.
Well, I hope that you know, as well as talking to me, that I would want you to be able to talk to your mom and, you know, even everyone at home. I want you to be able to tell your friends. Know that if you do feel that there's a burden from you onto them, I want you to be able to come in to me, and I don't want you to feel that way at all. I want you to be able to know. You can talk to me, talk about whatever you need to. Okay?
Okay, thank you.
Of course. So, with sleeping concerns that you're having, is it having any effect on school at all?
Kinda, yeah, because by the time I fall asleep, then it's really early in the morning versus
mm-hmm.
late at night, and then I can't get to class, or when I do get to class, the professor's talking, and that's when I can fall asleep, because
mm-hmm.
that's when I'm just not paying attention at all.
Mm-hmm.
So I get to the point where I get tired, so I have to fall asleep at some point, so that's when I fall asleep.
So
usually falling asleep right in class, so I don't pay attention, and then I don't get all the notes I need, I don't get the points that I had supposed to have for participation, because I'm not awake, so.
Mm-hmm. So, I don't know if you were noticing that those two have a correlation then, that they're connecting to each other.
Mm-hmm.
You're stressed out about school, you have anxiety about school.
Mm-hmm.
So you're thinking about it all night, so you're not sleeping.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're sleeping during class, So you're not getting what you need, and so you're having anxiety about that.
Exactly.
And so it's all a big circle. Have you possibly talked to your, any of your teachers about this?
No, because I don't want to be that one person that tries to be all close with the professor and have other kids think stuff. So I'm just like, just keep to myself and kind of try and teach myself things.
Okay.
As I go, but I mean, it doesn't always work.
I think that for next session, I want you to talk to at least one of your teachers. You know, even an email, maybe set up a meeting with them, office hours, or you know, something like that. Just one, and you know, just kind of maybe even introduce yourself. You know, tell them, you know, this is my first time in, you know, at college. I've never seen them from home. And just kind of see, you know, just see what you get for feedback.
They always seem so hardcore about things. Like, they tell you, like, this is college now. There's no excuses. And I just feel like, I don't want to be that one person who's like, well, I need an exception. So, it just scares me a little.
I definitely would get it, especially your first time. I would, be intimidated by, that it seemed like. But let's just try for next time. Just an email. Just saying, can we meet? I want to talk about just an assignment you have coming up. Just try and make conversation. Just try and see if that thought that's in your head is actually true. If it is true, then we can talk and maybe I can even help you try and figure out a schedule or anything like that, but I just want to have you see if that thought in your head is true.
Okay.
Okay? Does that sound like fun? Okay, good. Okay. So, I know we keep coming back to the sleeping, I feel like that's a huge correlation about what's going on with you and your schoolwork. Do you do anything at night, or do you just, lay in bed and think about everything?
Feel tired, so I figure, all right, I guess you're tired and you're not getting homework done, so lay down. Maybe sometimes I'll turn the TV on and the TV will just play whatever's on the television, just there.
Okay. What time do you usually try and fall asleep?
10, 11, usually. Gives up on me, so then I kind of just fall asleep, and then my alarm goes off, and hit snooze.
Okay.
And then, there's no turning back from there.
Okay. Can you think of a time for me, even in high school, that you said that that was a time where you weren't stressed out, had huge anxiety, is that a time that you slept well?
Yes.
Okay. What were you doing that allowed you to sleep like that?
Homework was easy. I had study hall for 45 minutes a day, so I'd take my homework there.
Okay.
Because I had it more towards the end of the day, I could just go in there, do all my homework, and then I'd go home, and I didn't have to worry about anything because my homework is already done.
Mm-hmm.
So I'd get it all done, go home, hang out with some friends, hang out with my family, be able to eat dinner with my family. So, I mean, I had more things that I could actually do rather than worry about, like, how's my homework going to get done? When is it going to get done? When am I going to sleep? Am I ever going to eat? So it's like everything is like crammed into one and I don't know what I'm doing.
Yeah, that's a lot to try and figure out, especially your first time, being away and trying to figure it out for yourself. That's a lot to take on at one time. Is there a time, I want to help you try and figure out something to get started to possibly, help with that sleeping habit. Is there a time during the week that you have 45 minutes that you can sit down and even work on just one piece of homework? paragraph of a paper. You know, five assignment, or, you know, five questions of an assignment.
I guess I have some time in between two of my classes, but
okay.
I usually try and lay down then because I'm still usually kind of exhausted in the night before.
Okay. How about, I want you to just try and fit that 45 minutes in for doing some of your homework.
Okay.
I know it might be really hard because I know you might be tired, and I definitely understand that you need your sleep, but hopefully we can get you onto a sleeping habit and sleeping routine that helps you sleep at a certain time to get you through that night, and then have that 45 minutes during the day, like you said, for study hall,
mm-hmm.
to at least get, you know, like I said, a paragraph of a paper done, two paragraphs of a paper done, something for you to sit down and have time to be able to sit and think about your homework. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
What do you think about that?
I guess I could try. It won't hurt. I mean, I guess I'm not sleeping that much anyway, so I guess if I can get homework done in the time that I'm thinking about my homework,
mm-hmm.
I guess it won't hurt.
I think more of what I want to try and help you with is getting a routine down to get good restful sleep at night. I want you to sleep at night and not in class. Do you think there's anything that we can do during the night when you're laying down that helps you get rid of anything? Any of those thoughts?
I mean, I guess if I'm getting some homework done,
mm-hmm.
I guess it would take some stress off of what I'm doing.
Okay.
So I might be able to, but I have to get homework done, so, I mean, I guess doing homework in between that 45 minutes, I probably could get some work done, and I might be able to be a little less stressed out. So, yeah, maybe doing some homework and not having to worry about it. And probably focusing in class, too,
okay.
So I can probably get my homework done faster.
Yeah.
So probably that, just being awake in class. Probably make me sleep more because if I'm sleeping, I can't pay attention, and then I don't have to reteach myself what I learned in an hour and 45 minutes, or at least was supposed to learn in an hour and 45 minutes in class. So maybe that.
Okay.
Other than that, I don't know.
Okay. I think that's a great start, and I'm really happy that, you know, you thought of that, and I definitely want you to keep trying to figure things out. And working things out. It's hard to fit in a busy schedule with so many hours in the day. What I like to do, and you know, maybe you can try this, is just maybe even 8 or 9 o'clock at night, just sit down, maybe after dinner, and maybe journal some things. Like journal your thoughts, anything that you're thinking of, your schedule, you know, your next day schedule, you know, your even just know, oh, today when I was walking, I saw, you know, anything. I think that trying to declutter what's going on, it will be helpful in having you fall asleep earlier and hopefully getting more restful sleep throughout the night.
Yeah, I guess so. My mom was telling me before that I should try writing down everything that I have due. So time consuming, but now that you're telling me it, maybe two people can cram it into my brain and I can get it together.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe that could work because then I can see everything in one spot and then I will have happy thoughts to write in that journal. Versus, oh, well, I fell asleep in class today, but I had a great nap while Professor so and so was teaching. So, maybe. So then I guess I could take some of that weight off my shoulders of, well, when's this due? When's this due? So, yeah. I could try that.
And I want you to know that this is going to be a process, and I enjoy having all of our visits, and I want you to keep coming back.
Mm.
But it is going to be, you know, a continuous thing that you are going to have to work on, okay? I don't want you to be discouraged. You're a very smart woman, and I know that you'll be able to do what you need to do to get through this. But I definitely want to help you and, you know, have, be there for you just to be able to talk about anything that's happening, the good, the bad. But, you know, I definitely see those sparks coming in and out and trying to figure out exactly what you can do to help yourself. I think that's a great thing to do.
It's getting hard being away from mom and dad, so at least there's someone here for me to talk to that I know isn't going to judge me or look at me like I'm crazy or something. So, thank you.
Of course. I know that you talked about your mom a lot, especially this session and last session. Have you ever thought about maybe writing letters to her?
Well, I mean, sometimes we FaceTime. Makes it even harder because I just miss them so much, but yeah, we try to communicate, but I know her life's busy and my life's busy, so we get to it when we can.
So do you think that maybe in between those FaceTime and calls, I think what I was trying to get out of the letter is everything that's happening in between. And you know, send them to her, you can wait till, you know, Thanksgiving or Christmas break to, you know, to even give them to her, I think as something to show her that, you know, not only that you miss her, but that you care about her too.
Maybe if I have some free time or my restless nights, I can wake up and write whatever down I'm thinking about, because I'm sure she'll be thinking about her too.
I think that's a great idea, and I can see that she is definitely someone that is there for you and someone that you look up to support you. So I think that's a great relationship that you have, but I want to help you be able to feel more connected with her being so far away.
Right.
Okay. With the few things that we've talked about today, you know, the journaling before bed, trying to get that 45 minutes in between classes and trying to do homework, just even getting back to bed sooner, you know, what do you see that as progressing through this, you know, semester in the next year? Do you see it as a positive? Do you think?
Yeah, because I feel like the more time that I can give myself to work on things, it'll start to make it easier, whereas I'm not trying to do everything minute, and it'll hopefully make it so that I can get more sleep.
Okay.
So,
yeah.
Sleep is my main priority, I guess. So I feel like if I get more sleep, then I'll pay attention in class more. And then the journaling, I feel like I can at least get out some of the emotions that I'm holding in by not talking to so many people around me, whereas like in high school, I was talking to everybody, now I'm here, new faces. Still trying to figure everything out, so I guess journaling will get out all that stuff, or all my emotions, everything that I'm holding in, get it all out, and I'm not bottling all in, makes me angry, or upset, or at least release some of those emotions, so that should hopefully help get my life back on track.
Okay. Well, I very much appreciate, you know, your feedback and what you think, and I really hope that take this next week and maybe fit a few of those things that I'm not saying all, because it's definitely, like I said, going to be a process. But I want you to take in these next, or this next week, take it maybe just a little bit of each thing, possibly, or just one, and just see what happens. Okay?
May I let me call you?
Of course.
If anything goes wrong.
Of course, so you have my number. Okay?
All right. Thank you.
All right, Claire, of course. Have a great night.
You too.
Thank you. Bye.
Oh, hey, Claire, come on in.
Hi, thank you.
How's it going?
It's going, I guess.
Alright, well, I mean, step by step, last session, we're kind of in the same area, but let's see how the week went. Do you remember what your assignment was for last week for me?
I had to go to, like, the student center and try and talk to a tutor about my math that I have.
Alright, how'd that go?
It was alright. I just kind of felt like I was being judged, kind of, sort of. I felt like everyone was, like, looking at me, trying to talk and get help.
Okay, so you kind of worried that people were judging you just because you needed a little extra help on something that you didn't really understand?
Yeah, I mean, I went in there for my math, and I already don't feel like I know what I'm doing, and I'm afraid to talk to the teacher because they obviously know everything that's going on.
Right.
And so when I went into the center, I just felt like everyone that was in there, like the tutors and the other kids, I don't know, I just feel like I just don't know anything. I just feel lost in this class.
Okay, so feeling lost, but you're at least going to get help. Like, you know that you're struggling a little bit, and you took that extra initiative to go and seek out more so that you know that you can do better in this class. So it's a next step. I mean, you may not understand it completely yet, but you are taking the next step to help yourself, right?
I mean, yeah, I guess. It's just one time, but I mean, I still don't feel like I got any help. I don't know if it's just me or just that I just don't know what I'm doing. I'm not sure.
Okay, so what all happened when you went in there?
I mean, I took my assignment in. We already had class, so I kind of understood, you know, I kind of remember what we were talking about that day. And then I was trying to explain it to the tutor, and I just felt like I wasn't doing a good job, and he didn't understand what I was trying to say to him. And, I mean, he knew what he was doing, and then when he tried to explain it to me, it just felt like what I was saying and what he was saying were just two separate things. And I don't know, I just felt like he was judging me, too. I just kind of felt embarrassed to be there.
Okay, so you're saying that you think that there was just confusion on both ends. When you were trying to explain to him, and the way you were explaining it to him wasn't exactly the same way that he was explaining it to you, so you still feel like you were getting nowhere, kind of like the same thing with class.
Kind of. I feel like it was my fault this time, and I guess in class I feel like it's my fault too, because I'm just not understanding what's happening.
Well, it's not your fault that you're not understanding. I mean, you're the student, you're learning, and that's what the professor's there for. So, just because you don't understand, that doesn't make it your fault. That just means that you just need a little extra showing to, because I'm sure while you're in class, the professor might be moving too fast, and you don't want to be the one to stop, so, but it's not your fault.
I mean, yeah, I guess I kind of understand that, too. I hate raising my hand in class, because I feel like even when the professor says, does everyone understand, everyone says yes, and I'm just in class, you know, like staring at my papers and the PowerPoints, not knowing what's happening, and I don't want to raise my hand and sound like the dumb one in class because I don't know what's happening, so I just ignore it and just keep going and hopefully, like, make some connections later, but I don't ever seem to do that.
So what exactly is stopping you from raising your hand in class because you feel like want to hold anyone else back, you don't want people making fun of you, or?
I don't know, I guess both of those. I just don't really want people to make fun of me, because, I mean, I feel like I'm in college now, I feel like I should understand. Like, it's just a basic math class, like, you know, I've never been good at math, but I feel like I've made it into college, and I feel like I should know what I'm doing, but I don't, so I just don't want to embarrass myself, and I just don't want people to make fun of me.
I mean, but it is a class, and you're there to learn. You wouldn't be taking the class if you knew everything that was already in there. So the feeling of some confusion, it's still okay, because it is a class. You're there to learn. The teacher is supposed to be teaching you, not they're just talking at you things that you already know. So it's okay to feel confused and not really understand all the material because it'll eventually come.
Mm-hmm.
It just might take that extra step, which is what you're initiating, which is good.
Mm-hmm.
May not, the first one may not have helped, but as long as you're going to class and still talking
mm-hmm.
with this tutor, I think it might help. Do you think you would care to go?
I mean, I guess it kind of makes sense that you said that, you know, if I didn't know it, or I already knew it, that I wouldn't be there. I mean, that makes sense to me. And then I am going to class every time that there's class. I just
right.
I don't want to miss class at all. I feel like I'll definitely be more behind if I do that. And I guess just the fact that the tutor, there are other kids in the tutor center. So obviously I'm not the only one that's going in there.
Right, right.
But I just, you know, I think I have to just keep going. I just feel like this is a huge process that I have to go through right now, but I'm slowly getting there.
Exactly. So you're taking the steps.
Mm-hmm.
It takes time. I mean,
yeah,
things aren't done in one day. You can't read a book in one day. You can't write all this material.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like a person just took all this stuff and put it in a book and they're like, okay, here
yeah,
you go, learn it.
True.
I mean, it takes time,
mm-hmm.
especially math. So, I think you're doing well. You're taking that first step. You're not defeating yourself. You're still going to class.
Mm-hmm.
So, you're still doing what you need to do, which is good.
Yeah.
All right. So, maybe next week we can continue. Maybe try and go one more time, see how it is.
Okay.
Keep up with your notes. You're doing well.
Thank you. Yeah, I'll definitely go again. I'll try to make an appointment next time, too, and just hopefully a longer time.
So when you're turning in your homework, what are you getting feedback back? What are your grades looking like?
I guess I get okay grades. I mean, I've gotten a few D's on homework assignments, but a lot of other times you're like C+, B- sometimes. But I just feel like, and just like checking my grades and stuff, and I feel like it's not where it's supposed to be, and I feel like, I don't know how to explain it, I guess I just feel like a failure, sort of, kind of. I know it's not that I am, but I just feel like, you know, I see people sitting next to me getting A+ on their homework assignments, and it's, there are people like saying the right answers in class, so I just think that, I'm not doing what they're doing, and I'm sitting in the same class as them. So I just don't understand how I'm not getting the same results as they are.
So, I mean, you're telling me that you don't feel like your efforts are correlating with your grades. So you feel like you're putting in so much time and effort into
mm-hmm.
this homework, and then you get back and your grades aren't reflecting the hard work that you put into it, which is a feeling to have. It's something you feel like, well, I'm doing so hard, I'm working so hard, I'm trying so hard, but the end result is not what I want it to be.
Mm-hmm.
And you feel like you see the people next to you, and they're doing better, and you're like, well, how come I'm not like that?
Mm-hmm.
Which, I mean, it's a valid reason to have.
Mm-hmm.
When you're getting this homework back, does your professor say anything to you?
Last few times, I mean, when I first started getting my homework back, I guess it was maybe just because it was easier. I was getting a little bit higher grades. The last two times I got D's, and he said come see me, but, I mean, I sent him an email, and he said to, you know, just come in my office hours, but I just didn't, then when we talked, and he said to go to the tutor, I just decided to go to the tutor instead of the teacher. So
you see your professor engaging in you. Which is good,
mm-hmm.
and you actually took that next step to email him
mm-hmm.
to see.
Yeah.
So you're emailing your professor, you're going to tutoring, so you still have these two things that you're doing
yeah.
that are helping you.
Yeah.
So though your grades aren't where they want to be now, you'll get to that next step.
Yeah.
You're working your way up that ladder, and you'll eventually get there. And I'm sure your professor sees you talking to him and going to the center.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to help you in the end. Whereas you're not sleeping in his class, so you're doing what you're supposed to be doing.
Yeah, I guess I just need to go talk to him. And, you know, it might help. Just the fact that I feel like I'm lost right now, and he may not even know it, or he may know it, but he's just waiting. But, you know, I don't know where I should be at right now, I guess. I just feel kind of lost. So.
Feeling lost is common when you don't really know what you're doing in class.
Mm-hmm.
And like you said, you want to go meet with your professor, see what you can do to help your grade, help you understand better, which is good.
Mm-hmm.
Really good. Is the effects of your homework, is it affecting anything else? I know last time we spoke, we were having a couple of issues with sleeping. How's that going?
It's okay. I mean, I feel like I'm trying to do my homework, and so I'm struggling with it, and so I feel like it should only take me maybe, you know, 45 minutes, but it's taking me like two and a half hours, and by the time I get to bed, it's, you know, like 12:30, and I have 8 a.m. classes, and I just feel like I'm not catching up, and then throughout the day, I have other classes and work, and I just feel like I never have time to just go to bed, you know, at a decent time. I'm always trying to do, plus all my other homework. It's just, it's definitely affecting, you know, me trying to at least get some sort of decent sleep.
So you're telling me that you're losing a lot of sleep at night because
mm-hmm.
you are worried about a lot of other things around you.
Yeah.
Okay. And when you are sleeping, how are you sleeping? Are you sleeping, like, do you fall right asleep when you lay down, or are you thinking about so many other things? Because I know you're saying that you're working.
Mm-hmm.
So what happens when you try and fall asleep?
I mean, I fall asleep pretty easily, actually, you know. But it's just, like, my roommate comes home or, you know, back to the dorm at, like, crazy times of the night. And she's always loud. And, you know, I've talked to my RA about it a few times. And, I do talk to my RA a few times about just kind of what's happening, that I'm having some issues with school and I just need, you know, to be able to get some sleep. But she comes home at like 3 a.m. sometimes and just like comes through and like turns on all the lights. So I feel like talking to my RA kind of helped, because she says if it continues, you know, she can't just remove her just because she comes home at late nights. And I guess maybe talking to my roommate will help a little bit. But I mean, like, once I fall asleep, but if she even comes home, like, or, you know, back to the dorm, it's just, like, I instantly wake up because she's just, like, going through, like, a tornado. So.
Okay, so what you're saying is you're sleeping, when you're able to fall asleep, even though you're getting a little bit of sleep,
mm-hmm.
you're able to fall asleep, but your roommate's causing a little bit of ruckus for you.
Yeah.
And that you're telling me that you went and talked to your RA,
mm-hmm.
which is a good thing.
Yeah.
Going to another person before in conflict between you and your roommate, knowing that you guys have to stay in the same room, so that's good. Did your roommate give you any other alternatives besides speaking directly to your roommate?
No, not really. She said that I pretty much would have to like figure it out for myself, which I mean, I understand. It's not, you know, a huge deal. It's not like she's, you know, being mean to me or, you know, taking any of my stuff or ruining my stuff or anything like that. She just says, like, if she wanted to, or if I wanted her to be there, if I would talk, she can. But other than that, unless anything, like, major happens, then I'm pretty much going to have to deal with it and figure it out for myself. So, I mean, that kind of stinks, but I'll just figure it out.
All right, so what do you think your next step might be with that?
I think I'm going to talk to my roommate. I feel like I never see her, though, so that's the hard part. So I think, like, starting that, I think that's going to be a huge deal and a conversation about it. So I think just starting it is going to be, like, okay, I guess, but I feel like as soon as I bring it up and, like, bring her up as the issue, she's going to, like, freak out and, like, make it a huge deal. So I guess I'm just kind of nervous to even bring it up. I just want to deal with it and, like, live with it for the next, you know,
Alright, so it's good that you want to bring this up to her so that you can sleep a little more at ease. You're pretty much saying that you're afraid
mm-hmm.
what might happen if you bring it up in a certain way or how you're going to address it.
Yeah.
Well, it's good that you see that, so then you can kind of prepare yourself for what might happen.
Yeah.
Is there any other options besides, like, if things don't go that way, is there any other option for you?
Not really. I mean, I guess I'll just have to kind of deal with it. I guess I'll just have to, you know, bring my RA into it if it does come down to that. But other than that, probably not.
Well, there's always the fact that you're able to go and talk to someone else, so you're not nervous or afraid to go and talk to someone else. So that'll definitely be a good step for you to take if your issue doesn't get resolved. So I think you should keep that up. As for the aspect of falling asleep late, do you think that it's helping going to see the tutor to kind of help you with your homework, or do you think that it's still leading into still having 2 hours on one homework assignment?
I mean, like we talked about last session, like, I know you said that the tutor's going to help, and, you know, now that I think about it, I feel like it'll help lessen that time on my homework, and maybe even I can get some more homework put into, you know, maybe that hour that I can get that done. So I'm definitely going to keep going back to the tutor just to be able to try and lessen that time and maybe go to bed at, you know, 10, 10:30 instead of like 12:31 and then be waking up 2 hours later,
right,
like not being able to go back to sleep. So you know, maybe those extra 3 hours will help, even if I do get still with me, you know, even if she still wakes me up. So, I don't know, I'm definitely going to keep going to the tutor, and definitely keep trying, and I guess just the fact that just trying to tell myself is what I need to do before I start, you know, blaming myself, too.
So. Okay. So it seems like you are already getting to that next level because you're understanding that if you continue to go and see this tutor, that you're gonna be able to slowly and surely start understanding what's in class. And then hopefully, if you can understand kind of the core values of what you're saying the tutor is helping you with, then that'll help you maybe understand a little more in class, and then you won't need the tutor as much as you are using him right now. So you can kind of use a little bit more of that time to get some more homework assignments done. Is the sleep with and the conflict with your roommate and the conflict you have in this one class, is that hurting any of your other academic areas, any of your other classes seeming to have a little downfall?
No, not really. I feel like it's, that's what I'm saying, like, I feel like just with that class, this is a general classes that I have, so it's not horrible, and I like English, and I like learning about all the stuff, but this math just, it's just no clue. So I feel like if I can try and get that to kind of ease some sort of stress and anxiety, it'll help just a little bit, but I mean, other than that, it's not really affecting my classes, I guess, just that class.
Okay, well, it's good that you do have those core classes that you actually like. So that's actually helping you can get that work done pretty easy. And then you are still struggling with that math homework, but can you remind me again what your major is?
Social work.
Social work, okay. So, I mean, you don't so much need that math class, so
yeah.
Once you get past it, you know you can move forward.
Yeah.
It's your first year, still falling into the routine of things, and like I was telling you, you're not the teacher, you're the student, so it's okay to be a little confused about the material that you are finding, and you're still handling it well.
Yeah.
You are moving forward, you're taking those next steps, so as for next week, what do we want to work on in this week that we're going to be away from each other?
I think I'm probably gonna at least go to the tutor maybe twice next week.
Okay.
I have a few homework assignments I have to kind of catch up on. So maybe just kind of helping me connect some of the dots. Maybe that's probably what I'm hoping for. So.
Okay. And then what about things with your roommate?
Ask her what exactly, you know, if we can figure out like a routine possibly, just, or maybe ask her just to kind of, you know, not come home at 3 a.m. Maybe try and do like midnight or 1. I don't know. But yeah.
Alright. So it looks like you have it all planned out. So, I mean, some good thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
Everything else going well for you?
I think so far. Yep.
Okay. Well, let's work on those things. If you have any questions or comments,
mm-hmm.
you know that you can call me, or if I'm not available, you do know that you have your tutor still,
mm-hmm.
and you have all the support here at the center. So if you have any other questions or any concerns, or if you just need to speak to someone right away,
okay.
you're more than welcome to give us a call. You do still have our phone number, correct?
Yes, I do.
Perfect. So are we okay to meet again next week?
Yeah, definitely.
Alright, well, it was good talking to you.
Thank you.
Just keep taking that next step. You're doing well.
Perfect. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have a good one.
You too. Thanks.
Bye.
Bye.
Come in.
Hi, my Claire. How you doing?
Good. How are you?
Good.
Have a seat there. So how has everything been going for you this week?
Oh, I mean, we're just going.
Going? Okay.
Like, things are continuing.
Okay.
Like, my life isn't ending. And everything just keeps, like, going. Like, still have to go to class.
Mm-hmm.
Still haven't made any friends. Excuse me, as a joke. See? Life continues. my roommate still sucks.
Okay.
I can't seem to get my grades up. I just, like, I just want it to stop, and I just want to stay in my bed or be by myself at some point. Like, it won't stop.
It sounds like you're feeling, you know, pretty overwhelmed right now. So why don't we do this, like we did that last session. I'm just going to have you do this little quick check-in so I can see where you're at for today's session.
Okay.
You do that. You can fill that out, and then just give it back to me, and then we'll go. Just circle it and then you can get back to me and we'll go over, talk a little bit about it.
Mm-hmm. Do I have to write out why? Or can I just, like,
you can just tell me. That's fine.
Okay.
Thank you. Okay. So, first of all, before we start this, I just wanted to set an agenda for today's session.
Okay.
Just so that we can figure out, you know, what the main thing we want to talk about today. So, if you could summarize, like, what is the one thing that's bothering you the most? Or a couple things that are bothering you the most?
I guess just how, like, I don't have any friends here.
Okay.
And then my roommate.
So your roommate, what is your roommate doing?
Well, she's just, like, keeps, like, being super loud, and, like, her and her boyfriend keep just, like, messing around in the I'm just like, I want to do my homework. I'm trying.
Right.
Like, I'm almost going to fail.
Right.
And it's just like, I get it. Like, trust me, I get it.
Yeah.
But, like, I need to do my homework.
Right.
And the only place I feel safe doing it is in the dorm. Like, safe in this way of, like, I'm not freaking out. I'm not looking over to see, like, is anybody looking at me? Like, it's my room. I just want to be able to use it.
So, it sounds like your roommate is causing a lot of stress, which is affecting other areas of your life.
Yeah.
And then you said that you feel really alone and isolated.
Yeah, because, like, I have nobody to talk to about this. Like, in high school, I had friends.
Okay.
Like, I'm not trying to make myself seem like a super great person, but, like,
yeah.
I had people I could talk to. I had people I could hang out with.
Mm-hmm.
I had friends that if I needed to go somewhere and just, like, chill for a little bit, like, we could go. and I get here and it's this giant school and I can't, it's just like my roommate's getting to me, I'm not doing well in school like I used to, everything's harder. I was an A student and barely getting by,
yeah.
So then like I can't make friends, I don't know anyone, I have nothing to connect with them.
But everything all together, just seems like it's all we've been through right now.
Yeah, like I just need a break.
Alright, so I think today we're going to focus on, you know, you're feeling alone and feeling overwhelmed, and then we'll also try to figure out some things that you can do with your roommate, or things to, you know, how to figure out that issue out, and then I noticed that you talked kind of down about yourself a lot, and so we're going to try to focus and address some of that negative self-talk, because that can really affect how you feel as a person, so, first of all, let's look at the check-in sheet. So, I see you circled three things, actually four things. Confused, frustrated, sad, and depressed. So, why did you circle confused? Can you tell me about that?
Because I just don't know, like, what I'm supposed to be doing right now.
Okay.
Like, it seems like everybody knows what they're doing, and they know what they're here for, they know who they're friends with. Like, nobody looks to just ever be walking around, kind of like, even just thinking, like, everybody has somewhere to go, and sometimes I have nowhere to go.
And you started just this semester, right? So you came in the middle of the year?
Yeah, and I feel like it was the biggest mistake.
Okay. I can definitely see how that could be confusing, because you said, like you said, it seems like everyone is established already at school, and you're coming in new. Trying to find
you
a place.
Mm-hmm.
Is that
right? I just want friends.
Yeah.
I just want to feel okay. And like I'm not a loser.
No.
Sitting by myself.
Right. Okay. And then I thought you felt frustrated, so I can sense your frustration. But tell me a little bit more about that one.
I'm just like with my roommate. I'm just like with everything. Easy. Everything was easy at school. Like, I knew where I was supposed to be. I knew my friends and the people I could talk to. Like, I don't know where I'm going. Buildings. This place is pretty huge.
Yeah.
My roommate, like, she doesn't even talk to me because half of the time her freaking face is on her boyfriend's face. Like,
okay.
God, you'd think she'd die of asphyxiation.
Well, That can definitely be frustrating, especially since you have to show them all the time. So we will figure out some things that you can do to talk to her, or we'll figure out another situation for her. And then the last two kind of go together, sad and depressed. So are you feeling sad and depressed because you're frustrated and confused with other things going on in your life?
I don't even know. Because it's like, I go from like being frustrated and like pissed off and so just like, I don't want to do anything. Like, what's the point?
Okay. Well, I think one of the things that I really am glad that you did is I'm glad that you were able to point that out, because that alone can be hard to do. So I'm glad that you were able to tell me about those things. So last week's session, we talked a little bit about the way I do things. And I told you a little bit about CBT.
Mm-hmm.
So you had the homework from last week?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
I can't remember the only homework I did.
Okay. So, I know, you know, you don't like homework because you've got a lot right now, but I'm hoping that, you know, if you have a little bit of free time, this will help you. So if you could, can you tell me a little bit about what you learned about CBT and how things affect one another?
Well, it's like a triangle, although like really it's like a circle, I feel like, because like you don't know where to start, except for like, clearly like, so I failed my stats test this week, and I freaking studied for it, like that's what I So, like I was feeling inadequate, and like I am a failure, and clearly depressed, and freaking worthless, and like, hopeless, because like I I was kind of heated when I wrote this. And then I decided to go to the cafe and just eat everything on my site. Always good. And then I didn't do any of my homework for my other class. Like, I just did this. Like, the moment I found out I failed, I was like, well, let's try and do this. And I'm like, well, I just angrily wrote.
Well, you know what? Even though that wasn't a great experience for you, it's really good that you're starting to see how everything, you know, your thoughts affect your feelings, affect your behavior. And you're right, it is more like a circle because there's no definite beginning or end point. It's just kind of keep going. But you can also, you know, if you change the way you think about yourself, it'll change maybe the way what you do. And so I think that's another thing that we want to talk about today specifically is, you know, What did you say about how you felt about yourself?
Like an inadequate failure.
Okay. So right there, it's a lot of negative self-talk that you're putting on yourself. And so, like, what if you said something like, I studied really hard, I tried my best, and now I know what I can do for the next test. Something like that. Because, you know what? Maybe what is your first test with that professor?
Yeah, but, like, I studied, so, like, I don't really know what to do.
But you know what? Like, every professor has different ways of, you know, testing. So now you know, oh, maybe this professor tests this way. They do kind of trick questions. I'm assuming maybe there are some trick questions on that. And then next time, you're better prepared. But that takes time. It's not going to happen overnight, but that's something to come with. So I'm really glad that you're able to make that connection. So that's a good first step. Okay, so I'm going to give you this so that we can go through this together because I think this will really benefit you. That's okay. Okay, so I'm going to probably get you a binder so you can put everything together because we'll help you organize stuff. So. Alright, so the first one, what does that say? All or nothing? So what does it say? Sometimes it's called
white thinking.
Right. So how did you feel about that test? So you failed that test, one test, and then you said you felt like,
well, like, but like I feel like that's like a thing that's like that's fine because like I failed the test, so like I'm a failure because I couldn't pass the test.
Wow, you failed that one test, but. Does that mean that everything else you do in life is a failure? Does that mean you as a person are not a failure? Or does it just mean that that one situation might not have gone the way you hoped?
I mean, I guess. I'm failing at everything right now.
We'll work on that one. Let's see. Let's look at another one. Sure. I remember earlier you said that you felt like you should have everything figured out by now. Like, feel like you should know what you want to do. Look at the one where it says should and must. Those words, like should, must, or ought, they automatically make you feel like you failed. Because if you should have done something, or you must have done something, there's a lack of something there. But instead, what if you do, or like to other people too, you can be like, my roommate should like me, or I should get along with my roommate. Things like that, that already put that expectation on there. So, you know, instead of should or must, you can be like, you know, you're 18 years old, you're good in high school, you're at a brand new school, it's going to take time, and you have 3 more years here to figure out what you want to do, because that's exactly what college is for. So you should, you know, like, try not to put that pressure on you, because that's a lot of pressure for a college student. So we're going to try to replace that type of thinking. Let's see, what's another one I hear that you can maybe relate to? Oh, I see one that I could mention for you. Do you see disqualifying the positive? So, it said discounting the good things that have happened or that you've done for some reason or another. So, you're putting aside all of your great things that you did in high school. I think you had mentioned earlier that you were like captain of your softball team, you were, when you were the editor of your paper, all of that don't matter. It's not like that goes away just because you're struggling now.
Well, like, everybody talks about how, like, college is this place to, like, reinvent yourself and, like, start over, and it's just, like, mm-hmm. it starts pretty shitty. Like, it sucks.
Well, you know what? You can put that over any day you want to, and I know that's not cliche, right? But you really can. Like, we can work on, from this day forward, making a fresh start for you here. I know, yeah, I know it seems like a lot right now, but we'll work on that apartment. So, this is going to seem really silly, and you're allowed to laugh, but I'm going to give this to you. It's literally a stop sign.
Okay.
And what I want you to do is I want you to think, okay, so what's something you think about yourself that could probably be considered a negative thought?
That could be considered or is?
Like, okay, so you failed the test throughout your whole life.
Okay, like, yeah.
Like, right?
I'm a failure because, like, I couldn't pass the test. Okay.
So I know it seems really silly, but I want you to think of someone going like this in your face, because the more aware you are that it is a negative thought and what it is doing to you, the more aware that you might be like, okay, I need to pause, I need to reframe, and I need to put, okay, why is this not true? So, you haven't failed at life because you did great in high school, and college is just one step in your life. Okay, let's try to do something else. Let's see. So, you remain the choice.
Yes.
What's something that, like, do you, well, since you don't get along with your roommate, do you feel like that's something that should be happening? Because college, I mean, that's often the case that
like, your roommate's supposed to be, like, one of your best friends that you make, like, the first people, and
but
it's just like, well, what the heck am I doing for this girl to be just, like, mean and, like,
yeah.
so inconsiderate, like,
it is. Yeah.
I didn't do anything for what?
I was gonna be like, okay, so what if it isn't about you? What if it's something about her? Maybe, you know, sometimes people just don't mesh, and that could be the case with you guys. I mean, have you talked about it with each other, or have you just kind of avoided each other?
Well, it's hard to talk to someone whose mouth is busy.
That's true. Well, I think maybe to work on that, we can talk to Harai, maybe, and see if they can help mediate between you two. And if that doesn't work out, we can probably try to get you another roommate, if that would help you in school, like, if that would help you with everything else.
So get my RA involved?
Yeah.
You think we can do that?
Yes, we can do that, because that's what they're there for. They're there to help you.
Aren't they just there to, like, make sure we don't kill each other and, like, bring in booze or something?
Well, that too, but, I mean, they're there to make sure that you're going to be okay with your roommate and that you're going to be successful in school. So, we can set that up. Want me to look into that for you?
Yeah, I mean, I didn't really know that was a thing I could do.
Yeah, we definitely can. So we'll all look into that for you. I'm actually going to give this to you. You can take that. You can do what you want with it. You can hang it on your wall and your drawing. You can put it in your binder. You can hide it if you want to.
Mm-hmm.
But I just want you to think about that, because you don't, you know, have to actually pull it out. But just think of pausing, stopping yourself, and just thinking about, like, okay, instead of, you know, turning myself negatively, what can I do? What are the reasons that this might not actually be true? And why, like, you know, maybe I can have another way of reframing that.
Yeah.
So we're going to keep working on that in our next session. But I just want you to start thinking about that.
Okay.
So.
I can try.
Okay.
Being nice to myself.
Okay. So we are near the end of our time. So I would like you, I gave you a pen and some paper. Real quickly, I just want you to write down a little bit of what you've learned today so that you can keep that with you, and then we'll talk about it.
Okay, what I learned. Steal your box.
as many as you want.
Can I give it to you?
Yeah, you can just tell me what you want.
Okay. Well, I guess I could just stop being so mean to myself.
Yeah.
And, like, look over this and not, like, jump to conclusions or, like, personalize things. Because I guess it can't be personal when my roommate technically doesn't know who I am. More personal with a boyfriend than me. Like the stop thing.
Mm-hmm. What about
so, like, question. So, yeah. Like, for the triangle, like, if I'm, like, I notice that, like, if I'm writing this or doing this, and, like,
yeah.
If I'm, like, feeling something and then I'm, like, thinking, like, when if I'm writing, be, like, I'm a failure and everything, could I, like, would that be a moment to be, like, stop?
Yeah, because you know, you're stopping yourself, okay, so you might feel this way, but then you're thinking about it, it's like, well, hold on, I'm upset that I feel this touch, but what's another way that I can look at it? So instead of, you know, taking that feeling of failure and that thought of failure and going, like you said, a cafeteria and just eating,
mm-hmm.
maybe you can be like, well, I tried my hardest, I studied, that's something positive, something I'm going to study. And like, what can I do to celebrate that? And maybe, you know, you could go for a walk outside or go watch a movie that you really wanted to see. Something like that. Because you tried your hardest and that's something to celebrate.
Okay. I can do that. So that was it, right?
Okay. No, I think I'm happy that you were able to get that session because that's what our main focus was today was to talk about that negative self-talk and see just show you some ways that you I'm glad that's what you got out of it. So how did you feel about today's session? Do you think it was too much homework or do you like the homework? What are your thoughts?
No, I mean, like, it's not my favorite thing to, like, do a worksheet, but, like, I get it. I see it. Like, I'm a visual person, so I, like, seeing it helps and, like, it's hard. Like, I feel like I'm being super negative, and like you said, I am being negative.
Right. But,
and, like, kind of fighting you, but it's just, like, it sucks. And, like, it's, I don't
it's
know.
It's kind of your helping. Life, though.
Like,
yeah.
you're helping. It's just.
Good. I mean, I just, you know what? You can use that as much or as little as you want to. I just wanted to provide you with that so you have the tools if you need it.
Yeah, I appreciate it. I just, nobody likes to admit that they have to make friends. Like, nobody likes to admit that you're like 5 years old again in your playground and you're like, can you play with me? Can you play with me?
You know what, though? That's absolutely not true about you. At a playground school, you don't know anybody. The kids here, they've already had that benefit of meeting each other, you know, on the first day of orientation and all of that. So that is natural. And you know what? I think maybe next session we can talk about some of the things that you're interested in so we can get you involved in some on campus groups. And I think that will really help you find people that you want to connect with. Because I know right now you're not connecting with your roommate, but I bet you can find people maybe on the softball team. Or maybe there's a school journal or something that you can write for. So we'll look at that in our next session. And then do you have any questions or things that you'd like me to do for the next session?
No, I guess just like find out if I can get my RA involved. Or like really who my RA is, I guess.
Okay. I'll find out, and then I'll contact her, and then we'll set up a meeting.
Okay, but, like, are you going to tell her?
No, I will let you tell about the situation.
Okay, so then are you
just going to talk to her just you two first, and then if you decide to move forward to talking with the woman, she can probably lead that meeting. And then lastly, this is something that you don't have to bring back next week, but it would be very beneficial. It's everything that we talked about today, so it's called a thought record, and I'm going to have you, if you have any negative thoughts that got to you, I want you to write them down sometime this week. You can just journal, just jot them down, they don't have to be, you know, perfect. And then just write down some alternate thoughts, write down some reasons why this negative thought might not be valid, and then how you're feeling, just all of that, because it's good to be able to see it on paper, so you don't have to do it, but I'm going to give you that. Okay. Well, thank you for the feedback. I'm very glad you came today. And we will set up. I'll contact you IA and we'll set up an appointment. Okay?
Okay.
Thank you, Claire.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
You too.